Hello all, welcome to my channel Learning Oasis. So this video is going to be a continuation of the previous video. The previous video I posted was how to merge multiple Excel files into a single file using Power Query. But there are some questions raised from few of you because in that video, whatever sheets that we were trying to combine, everything had a same number of column and it was in the same order. But there were questions, what if the column count differs? And similarly, what if the columns are jumbled? Can we still able to merge the files? Okay, the answer is yes, we can do. Using Power Query, we can write a lot of codes and then combine it, but that is going to be a time-taking process. And the prime goal of this channel is to simplify complex activity. So I'm not going to explain how to do the coding and other stuff, but instead I have come up with a simple solution. So please watch this video. So before proceeding to it, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe it. So these are the three files that we have. Okay, so the first file is 2019 and here I have four columns: name, location, degree, and then the year that they were passed out. And the second file is 2020. Here I have an additional column which is email, and also if you see, the pass out which was in the last column is in the second column here. Okay. We have a third file wherein we have six different columns. If you see, there is another column which was newly added as placement at the end. Okay, so what are we going to do to accomplish this activity of merging all these files together without writing any code? Okay, the trick is very simple. What I'm going to do is I'm going to have an additional file created. Okay, this is a helper file that I have created. It's an absolutely blank file. So watch carefully what I'm going to do. So I'm going to the first file, which is 2019. And I'm going to copy the headers. This is really going to be a simple trick. So please watch it carefully. So I'm going to paste it. Just I'm going to use the transpose option and then paste it as a column. And I'm going to the second file and copy these data. Do the same thing. And then go to the last file, copy the header, transpose and paste it. Now select this, go to data, remove duplicates. So the reason I'm doing is there are column names that are same across the file. So I just want to get rid of that. So I'm going to remove it. So again, I will copy this and transpose and then paste it so that I'll get it converted into rows. So I'm going to clear this off. We are done. I'm just going to give a random data here just to fill in the details. So the data is ready, save this. Now open up a new file, or rather the file where you want to merge this. Just make sure the file that you are trying to merge and where you want the resultant file, both should not be in the same folder. Both has to be in the separate folder. So now go to a blank sheet, go to the data tab, get data from folder. This is the folder where I have all the files that I want to be merged. So I'll open that and then click on transform data. So just one change here. Previously, when we were using the normal merge option, we converted everything into a table and then tried to merge it. But here we will not convert anything into a table. The data will be as such, and then we are getting into the Power Query. And this is where we are going to make a slight modification to the previous steps that we were using. So by default, it will show the first file. First file will be the 2019 file that is on the top of the folder. But instead of that, here I'm going to select the helper file and then click on sheet one. It will give you a preview data. So if you remember, this is the data that we had in the helper sheet. Now I'm going to click OK. So it will evaluate the query and then give you the preview of the final data. Okay, so here you go. So this data is for 2019, and if you see, the email and then the placement value will show up as null because it doesn't have a column named email and then placement. So if you remember, in the file 2020 file, the email column was in the second column, but even that has been rearranged here to the exact requirement based on the helper file that we have given. So now let's load this data, click on close and load, and the data will be populated here. So just to verify it, so let's go to the 2019 file. What do we have? Name, location, degree, and then pass out. So in the final file, so we have name, location, degree, and pass out. Email and placement is blank. Let's go to the second file. 2020, we have name, pass out, email, location, and degree. So the new one is the email that is being added here. And if you look at 2020, yes, here you go. Name, location, degree, pass out, and then email. Similarly, for the last one, you should have an additional column, which is the placement. So it is also there. For 2021, it is there. So this is the final output that you're going to get. And the helper file data, whatever we had, that is going to show up in the end. If you choose to delete it, you can just select it and then delete it. Similarly, what if you want to add an additional column? Do you think it will work? Yes, it will. So I'm going to add here. So I'm going to add a column country. So let's say it's US. And I'm just going to drag this data and then save it. Before you go to the final output file and then refresh it, all you need to do is go to the helper file again and then add in a new column. Country, and I'm giving a random data here. Save it. Now go back to the resultant file, and then all you need to do is just right click and refresh. So you had another column added, which is country. So we added it in the 2021 file. Just cross check it. It is there in the 2021 file. So this is a simple trick. Instead of using all codes and other stuff, this is a much easier option. Even a newcomer to Excel with some basic knowledge can utilize this. I hope this video was helpful. If you like this video, just hit the like button and share it with your friends to whom you think this could be useful. Thank you all.